Hello dear student, good afternoon to all. So today I am going to start our next method of FYM preparation, that is Goberges plant slurry method, and third one, that is enriched FYM method. So last lecture we discussed on first method, that is trench method, that recommended by C.N. Acharya, as well as then classification of organic minerals, bulky organic minerals and concentrated organic minerals with their examples. Okay, as well as also we studied last lecture, that is factors affecting composition of FYM. Okay, so today I am going to start Goberges plant slurry method. Okay, so this method is the anaerobic method of decomposition of FYM. Okay, so firstly we discuss on what is biogas. So biogas, it is the comprises of hydrogen and carbon. It consists of hydrogen and carbon, which combustible and can produce heat, also energy when it is burned. That is biogas. And see the basic principle of biogas, that is it is generated, the bacteria degraded by biological material in the absence of oxygen. And this process is known as anaerobic digestion. Okay, when biogas is a mixture of methane also known as a marsh gas or natural gas, that formula is CH4, and carbon dioxide, it is a renewable fuel produced from waste treatment. That is basic principle of biogas. Okay, then see the method of how to generate methane gas from plant. So in India, normally 50% dung, it is made the cakes for burn purpose, okay, as a fuel purpose for cooking the different foods, as well as cultivator use the cow dung as a plant produce combustible gas called methane. It is improved method of handling FYM. In that, firstly, important objective on that, which gas can produce the in Goberges plant, that is methane, and this method is anaerobic fermentation method. Aerobic means decomposition in the presence of oxygen, and anaerobic means decomposition in the absence of oxygen. Okay, this is the aerobic and aerobic and anaerobic decomposition method. So Goberges plants method is the anaerobic fermentation method. So firstly, in that Goberges plant mainly two parts, that is digester and gas container. Okay, so in that digester and gas container, the digester is the type of well which is dug in below the ground level, having a depth, the size that is 370 to 610 centimeter height, okay, with 120 to 610 centimeter diameter. This height, okay, height is 370 to 610 centimeter, and their diameter, that is 120 to 610 centimeter diameter, depending on their capacity, okay. Then it has two slanting cement pipes, okay, these two slanting cement pipe, that is inlet and outlet, okay, that is inlet and that is outlet pipe. Okay, also fresh dung well mixed with water flow into the digester through inlet pipe, okay, in that mixing tank, and after decomposition for nearly a month, it comes out in the form of slurry through the outlet pipe and stored in the manure pit. Okay, after fully decomposition, it is transferred in that pit and it is removed from that tank in outlet pipe and come after flow tank. Okay, that is the basic structure of Goberges plant. Okay, then see, after drying, that slurry can be used as a manure in the farm. Okay, this slurry, there is the slurry from getting outlet plant. Then using the decomposition process, methane can be produced in the stored in the bank container as well as which is drum constructed of mild steel sheet. Okay, and they have supply up to pipes, fitted pipe on the drum, which carries methane gas for cooking to the desired place or kitchen. Okay, so this is the biogas plant slurry method. In biogas method contain minerals, after decomposition it is quite rich in nitrogen, also it contain phosphorus and potassium, okay, as well as micronutrient like zinc, sulfur, iron. And gobar gas plant is extremely cheap and it is made by locally available material. Okay, so this is the method of biogas preparation. So in that method is only important is the which gas is produced, the okay, outlet pipe, inlet pipe, and the size of that plant. Okay, and also it is the anaerobic decomposition method or anaerobic fermentation method is important for objective. Then see third method, that is enriched FOM method. But before that we discuss some average maximum biogas production from outfront feedstock. If you using dung, it contains 60% methane and it uses 350 kilo dry matter, means using 350 kg dung that contains 60% methane. In night soil, 65% methane. Poultry manures, in spill poultry droppings, 65%, dry leaf 44%, sugarcane trash 45%, maize straw 46%, and straw powder that is 46% methane. So these some examples are produce methane gas. Then see enriched FOM method. In this method, mainly used the addition of chemical preservatives like gypsum and superphosphate. Okay, calcium sulfate is the gypsum and superphosphate. So chemical preservative are added to FOM, decrease the nitrogen losses. Okay, nitrogen losses from evaporation or leaching down. That preservative are applied in the cattle shed to permit direct contact with the liquid portion or urine. Also these are commonly used chemical preservatives like gypsum and superphosphate. So in gypsum has been used for preserving the nitrogen from many years in foreign countries. Okay, like superphosphate is mainly recommended in India only, it's not used a gypsum because in Indian condition superphosphate is suitable as compared to gypsum. So see some first reactions with gypsum and ammonium carbonate. It is firstly ammonium carbonate, okay, ammonium carbonate is reacted with gypsum, that is formula of gypsum, that is calcium sulfate. It form calcium carbonate and ammonium and sulfate. Okay, in that ammonium, intermediate product of ammonium decomposition, urea is present in urine. Also with this action, ammonium carbonate is changed into stable salt as a ammonium sulfate. Okay, this is stable salt, that is ammonium sulfate. As long as manure is moist, also no loss of ammonia occurs. This ammonia is not volatilized easily. But if manure become dry, the chemical reaction is reversed and the loss of ammonia occurs. Okay, because this reaction is reversed and form ammonium carbonate, and that ammonia carbonate is evaporate easily. That's why therefore gypsum is not suitable under Indian condition to decrease the loss of nitrogen. Okay, it is the reaction of gypsum with FOM or any material. Okay, in FOM present ammonium carbonate. Okay, then see reaction with superphosphate, second preservative, and this is suitable for Indian condition. Superphosphate contain 50 to 60% gypsum beside monocalcium phosphate. So in this action, superphosphate is similar to gypsum, okay, but superphosphate, it in the reaction tricalcium phosphate is formed, which does not react with ammonium sulfate. Also, when manures become dry, as such as no loss of nitrogen or ammonia. Okay, in that reaction, calcium sulfate means gypsum is reacted with monocalcium phosphate, that is CaH2PO4, monocalcium phosphate formula, and also ammonium carbonate present in FiN. Okay, these after their reaction we produce tricalcium phosphate and ammonium sulfate, and that ammonium sulfate is not easily evaporated. Ammonium carbonate is easily evaporated, but it is not easily evaporated, as well as byproduct is formed water and carbon dioxide. This is the superphosphorus reacted with ammonium carbonate, and that ammonium carbonate is present in FIM or any manures. That's why in superphosphate is important, or it is suitable in Indian condition. Okay, so this is recommended at 40 to 450 to 900 gram of single superphosphate should be applied per day. Okay, per day per animal in the cattle shed, and it is applied in places where animal pass the urine. Okay, means the application rate is 450 to 900 gram, means half to approximately 1 kg of SSP, single superphosphate, should be used applied in cattle shed, as well as in urine contain urea as in the main constituent. That's why urea is capable to convert it to ammonium carbonate in the presence of moisture. Okay, then see, the ammonium carbonate is not stable compound, and it is decomposed to produce gaseous ammonia, which is lost atmosphere. Okay, so urea in urine, this is the reaction of urea in present urine, that is CONH2 2, and it reacted with water and form ammonium carbonate, but it is not stable product. That ammonium carbonate reacted again water and form ammonium hydroxide and carbonic acid, and that carbonic acid is the weak acid. Okay, and that ammonium hydroxide, it form gaseous ammonia and water. Also, that gaseous ammonia evaporate easily. Like it smell ammonia in the cattle shed, it indicate the loss of nitrogen from urea in urine. This is the reaction of urea in urine. Okay, it losses the gaseous form from urine. Okay, this is the second method of FIM preparation, that is enriched FIM method. Okay, in that important is which preservative used for that method, that is gypsum, and which method, second one, super phosphate, like single super phosphate, and which is suitable for Indian condition, that is super phosphate, means single super phosphate. Okay, then see, losses during handling and storage of FIM. It have three losses. Firstly, the solid means dung, liquid means urine, and losses during storage. So firstly, we discuss on losses of liquid portion or urine. Okay, when losses, that is approximate, when floor of the cattle shed is uncemented or not well cemented. Also, when liquid losses or urine loss, when animal, particularly bullock, kept in field during summer season for feeding purpose or fodder purpose. Also, large quantity of nitrogen are lost through the formation of gaseous ammonia. Okay, that is the gaseous ammonia it loss from urine. Okay, that is the loss of ammonia from liquid portion or urine portion. Then second, loss of solid portion or dung. That is use of dung as a fuel, means in Indian 50% dung used of as a fuel or making the cakes. Then second loss during occurs when milch animal go out for grazing, okay, for feeding the grasses. Then third loss during storage, that is evaporation loss, okay, as well as leaching loss. In that leaching, losses of nitrates that monocalcium phosphate and nearly 90% of potassium salt will be leached down. And volatilization means during storage, ammonia is produced in the manure's heap from decomposition of urea and nitrogenous compound of their urine. They evaporate the ammonia in gaseous form and H3 form. These are the losses during handling and storage of FYM. Okay. Then see, first in losses during storage in evaporation loss, that is reaction will take place. Urea and other nitrogenous compounds like urine, dung, that is ammonium NH3, that NH3 and carbonic acid reacted each other and form ammonium carbonate. Okay, and that ammonium carbonate again reacted with water H2O. Okay, and that H2O and ammonium carbonate form ammonium hydroxide and carbonic acid. That ammonium hydroxide and ammonia and water form, that ammonium hydroxide form ammonia and water in the gaseous form. Okay, so this is the volatilization loss due to leaching. Then control, how to control their losses? It makes pakka floor or cemented floor for better cattle shed having a impermeable floor to prevent the soaking of urine. Then second, addition of gypsum or bedding material to absorb urine. Then use of rock phosphate. Rock phosphate is a stable compound that's of ammonium sulfate and calcium phosphate are formed. Then second method, third, fourth method, that is maintain the optimum moisture to avoid the loss of ammonia in the gaseous form. Next, minimum turning to control the loss of nutrient to exposure to the sunlight. It's control the turning of that FIM. Then better storage method means manure heap or pit may be provided with the roof to prevent the entry of rainwater as well as exposure to the sunlight. And then last control or loss control method, that is use of cow dung gas plant in that to satisfy the fuel demand as well as preserving the mineral value of cow dung. These are the control losses, how their control of FYM preparation. Okay, I will prepare some important objectives on manures in that three methods of FYM preparation, in that trench method, Gobar gas plant slurry method and enriched FYM. In trench method, important objective on CN Acharya recommended that method. In Gobar gas plant slurry method, methane gas can be generated in anaerobic fermentation method. Also, it have mainly two parts like digester and gas container, and average maximum biogas production from different feedstock. That is chart. Okay. Last slide we discuss on that chart. Then enriched FYM method, in that important chemical preservatives like gypsum and superphosphate. In that superphosphate is suitable for Indian condition. Then this chart is also important in that edible and oil cake nutrient content and non-edible oil cake nutrient content. So in non-edible oil cake, neem cake contain 5.2% nitrogen. In edible oil cake, around 7.9% nitrogen in safflower cake, decorticated. Okay, so this is important. This chart is also important for objectives purpose. Then see organic manures in that bulky and concentrated organic manures. In bulky organic manures, FYM content 0.4. It is approximately, means it is a 0.5% nitrogen, 0.2 to 3% phosphorus, and 0.3 1.9. It approximately means 0.5% K. Also green manures means leguminous crop content 0.3 to 0.85% nitrogen, 0.12 to 0.20% phosphorus, and 0.5 to 0.6% K2O. In concentrated organic manures, 10% nitrogen present in meat meal, 2.5% phosphorus present in meat meal, also 0.5% potassium. And guano is the excreta of seabird, It contains 7 to 8% nitrogen, 11 to 14% phosphorus, and 2 to 3% potassium. So this chart is also important for objective purpose. If any difficulty regarding Mandro's topic, you can message me or call me. Okay, thank you.